students, how are you all? I hope you all are doing good. Children, as you all are aware that we were doing chapter 7, weather, climate and adaptation, in which in the last class we had started with a third important topic of this chapter, that is adaptation. Adaptation means the feature and habit that allow or that help that particular animal to survive in that condition in which they live. So that is known as adaptation. Like polar bears who live in a polar region of north or south region, their body is quite thick, having fat stored inside their body, which provide them support and which provide them a warmth to live in that such kind of a cold environment. So in the previous class we have done some of the adaptation of the general animals, those who live in polar region, whether they were living in north region or they were living in south region. So today I am going to take particularly an animal about adaptation in polar bear, adaptation in penguins, adaptation in Siberian cranes, what all adaptation they will be having which help them, or features or the physiology we are going to talk about, what kind of a physiology they have, what kind of a features which are inbuilt in their bodies which help them to adjust in that kind of an environment. So the first thing is adaptation in polar bear. The first thing is the white color of polar bear. If you have seen in any picture also, you will finding it out that polar bears are white in color. And this white color of polar bear helps them a lot. It helps them to hide themselves in snow so that predator won't be able to find it out, those polar bear. And it will also help to find prey also. So their prey can also, their food can also, won't be able to see that then. So that white fur of polar bear will help them a lot. So now in this adaptation in polar bear, because of white fur, polar bears are not detected by the predator in the snowy white background. So since their white color fur hide behind the white snowy background, and this process and this kind of a hiding feature is known as camouflage. And yes, polar bear are doing camouflaging. Now, so what we are going to write about the first adaptation, that white fur of polar bear helps them to hide in snowy background and catch their prey. So this is one of the way like what this adaptation of polar bear helps them. So the first way is white fur of polar bear helps them to hide in snowy background. Since the color of snow is also white, and due to that white color, polar bear hide themselves behind the snow, and then they can catch prey. So it also helps them to protect from predators. So this, now you are going to see that each and every physiology psychology and physical feature of polar bear was so concerned in helping them to adjust in that environment. Now this hiding white fur behind the snowy background is known as camouflage, and yes, polar bears are doing camouflaging, hiding them behind the snow, and then they had an eye on their prey also. They catch their food by using this adaptation, and also they hide themselves behind the snow to protect from or to get protection from the predator also. There is somebody or there is some other animal who want to eat that polar bear also, and that can harm polar bear. So by using this camouflaging, polar bear can hide themselves also behind that snowy background. Next is thick fur. The thick fur of polar bear that prevent the loss of heat of the body and protect bears from extreme cold. Now second adaptation is the thick fur of the thick fur of their body. Now thick fur of their body prevent the loss of heat, prevents the loss of heat, prevent the loss of heat and protect them from cold, and protect them from cold, protect them from cold. So these few things are very important, protect them from cold. Now what is the second adaptation? That thick fur of their body prevents them from the loss of heat. Inside, whatever heat which is already present inside their body, that will not be lost, as well as it will be protect them from cold also. So that is second adaptation. The first adaptation is the white fur of polar bear, which help them to hide themselves behind the snowy white background, and then they can catch their prey, as well as it will help them to protect from their predator also. Second is the thick fur of their body prevents heat loss, and this will also help them to survive in the extreme cold. So these are the two adaptation. Now next I am going to write it down. The next adaptation of polar bear is, the next adaptation of polar bear is that thick layer of fat under the skin is called blubber, and it provides additional insulation to their body. So thick layer of fat which is known as blubbers. So thick layer of fat which is present under their skin, it helps them to protect them from extreme cold under the skin. So a thick layer of fat which is known as blubber, it provides, helps in, helps like insulation of, helps in insulating their body. Insulating their body means they will be providing a layer of covering which help them to protect from extreme cold. They provide insulating their body. So this only works like an insulation. What is insulation like? on wire we have a covering over that wire, and it will that wire will help to protect the electric shock of that. Electric shock will be protected by that. So thick layer of fat, which is known as blubber, helps in insulating their body, helps in insulating in their body. Now, wide and large paws. If you look at the hand and feet of polar bear, they are wide and large paws, which help the polar bear in walking on the snow. If their paws will be quite small, then they will move inside the snow and they won't be able to walk on the snow easily. So wide and large paws. Fourth, adaptation, wide and large paws. Wide and large paws helps them to wide and large paws helps them to walk on snow easily. So that is one of the adaptation. You can see that this feature is already present in their body. And why that feature is present in their body? Due to this. Since they are supposed to walk on snow, and if they have small paws, then they won't be able to walk on the snow easily. Then the ability to close nostrils enables them to remain underwater for long time. They have the ability to close the nostrils. Then during winters, polar bear go for a long winter sleep. So during winters, polar bear hibernate. Long sleep during winters is known as hibernation. And polar bear do hibernation during winters. They sleep for 2-3 months, 3-4 months, and once the winter will be over, they can sleep up to 6 months. So before that, they keep on eating and storing fat in their body, and the fat which is stored in their body, it provides them energy while they were sleeping. So during winters, the fifth one is during winters, polar bear do hibernation. Polar bear do hibernation. They go for a long sleep of few months. So they hibernate during winters. So hibernation is what? That is long sleep during winter is known as hibernation. Now they have keen sense of smell, hence which helps them to locate their enemy as well as the prey. That they can take smell of their prey as well as predator also from a long distance. And this adaptation helps them to get the prey easily. And if there is any predator who is sitting besides them, they can also catch them also. Now that is very important, this, that during winters polar bear do hibernation. Hibernation is what? Here only I'm going to write it down. Hibernation is what? Long sleep during winters. And this long sleep, it is not only done by polar bear, by any other earth, by some many more animals were doing hibernation. So that we are going to discuss later. First we will do what all adaptation does polar bear has, which help them to survive in such kind of an environment, in polar region, in north region, where the temperature can varies and can goes lower down up to minus 37 degrees Celsius. So here first, which we have done, that due to their white color fur, they can hide themselves behind a snowy background, and they can catch their prey as well as they can protect them from predator. This is first and foremost important adaptation of polar bear. Now hiding themselves behind the snow, that is known as camouflage. And yes, polar bear are doing camouflaging. Number two is a thick layer or thick fur, which prevent loss of heat from their body and also protect bear from extreme cold. When there is a lot of cold, their furs are just work like a blanket, and it will protect them from extreme cold. Number three, which here I have written, that thick layer of fat, which is known as blubber, helps in insulating their body. Now, this thick fat of polar bear, it help like an insulation. Like a polar bear, they keep on eating during summers. They keep on eating, and stored all the food and some part of the food in their body in the form of fat. When inventors they go for hibernation, that food is going to provide them energy. Now, wide and large paws. The hands and feet, if you will see of that polar bear, they are quite large paws, which helps them to walk in snow. If they have small paws, it will move inside the snow and they cannot take it out from that snow. And they cannot walk on snow easily. Number five, during winters, polar bear do hibernation. Now, what is hibernation? Hibernation is the long sleep during winters. Long sleep during winters. So, they have a power of keen smell. Sense of smell is very strong of them. And they can smell prey as well as predator also. One more thing which is very important, that the ability to close nostrils. They can close their nostril for such a long time and then they can move inside the water. And when any fishes will come, they can catch those fishes and other aquatic animals. So that is also one of the adaptation. These five easiest one I have written, that you can note it down and that you can remember these adaptation. Now we'll come to next adaptation in penguins. What all the adaptation do we have in penguins? Penguins can protect themselves by camouflaging. Now most of the animals, those who live in snowy areas, they use this camouflage. It is not like that camouflage is used only by the animal, those who are living in snowy areas. It is used by the animal, those who are living in land area also. Now, penguins can protect themselves by camouflaging. They have white feathers on the belly, which help them to merge with the surrounding, with the white surrounding, and protect them from predator. Again, penguins also, they will also do camouflaging. They hide them. So let's write it down. What are the adaptations which penguins use? Now penguins are also will find penguins in the polar region only, and most of the penguin, or if you have seen penguin picture, that they move in a group. They move together. They are moving in a group. Adaptation is in penguins. Now penguins also, they also use camouflage. Adaptation in penguins, they also, penguins can protect themselves by camouflaging. They have white feathers which hide behind the white snow. So penguins can protect themselves by camouflaging. Now this, what is the meaning of camouflage, that you must be knowing. That's why only you can write it down. Camouflaging. So penguins are also using this camouflaging technique to hide themselves behind a white snow, and their predators cannot find it out them. Their prey cannot won't be able to see them, and then they can easily get the food. Now next is, second is, penguins have thick layer of fat again under the skin, which protect them from extreme cold. Again, penguins have layer of fur, thick layer of penguins have thick layer of fur, of fat under skin, which protects them from extreme cold, Now, what do you mean by extreme cold? When the temperature of that particular place is more than like minus 35, minus 40 degrees Celsius, then that is known as extreme cold. In such kind of a condition, penguins can survive just because of the thick layer of fat which is stored inside their body. Their skin are quite thick, and within that thick skin, they stored lot of fat inside their body. Now, they are good swimmer. Now, how it helped them to adapt in that particular environment? Now, they were living mostly in north and south region, and there they will be mostly living near the ocean areas. So in ocean, they have streamlined bodies so that they can swim easily inside the water, and webbed feet which help them to swim. Now, why do they swim inside the water? So that they can get food inside the water. They can get fishes inside the water. Then they have thick feather which save them from biting cold and make their body surface waterproof. So, next point is that they are a good swimmer. Their streamlined body, flattened flippers like wings, and webbed feet help them in swimming. So they have such kind of a body. Now these two, that is penguins, can protect themselves by camouflaging. Number two, penguins have thick layer of fat under skin which protects them from extreme cold. These two points are very important related to adaptation of penguin. Now we are going to write the next point, that is they are good swimmer. Penguins are, number three is, they are good swimmer. They are good swimmer now they are good swimmers and their adaptation or their body is such kind of a that it will help them to swim. Now they have streamlined body. They have streamlined body just like a ship. They have streamlined body, flat flippers and webbed feet. Now all these adaptations, they have streamlined body, flat flippers, webbed feet, which help them to swim. See, all these adaptation in penguins is just because of survival. Just because to survive in such kind of a weather. Now here what is there? That they are good swimmer, yes. Why they are good swimmer? Since their body is such kind of a structure that they can swim inside the water easily, they can find their food easily, they can live in that particular environment. Then they have thick feathers. Next, number four, which protect them from severe cold? They have thick feather, which protects them or saves them? Protect them from severe cold. So severe cold environment, when there is lot of like very low temperature will be there in that particular area. So at that time, all these adaptation, like they have thick feather which protects them from severe cold, they are good swimmer, they have flat flippers, streamlined body and webbed feet, which allows them to swim inside the water easily. So, and the first two, like which we have done, like the first one, that penguins can protect themselves by camouflaging, since their white color is hide behind the snow and predator won't be able to find it out. Next is, penguins have thick layer of fat which is stored inside and which protects them from extreme cold. From severe cold, their thick feathers are there which help them to, they are holding each other in a group, and then they become and they share the warmthness. Now penguins live in a group and remain huddled together. This keeps them warm and prevents heat loss. So if you have seen a picture of penguin, you must have found it out that always a penguin, in a picture of penguins, they were moving in a group only. They were moving in a group only. They are not going to move alone. So penguins live in groups and remain huddled, means they are quite close to each other, and this keeps them warm. This will keep them warm and prevent heat loss. This will help them to keep warm and heat loss will be prevented. So that is very important feature. Now hibernation and blubber, these two words, camouflaging, these three words are new in all these adaptation of the animals, those who live in polar region, in which we have done adaptation of penguin and adaptation of polar bear. Now yesterday I was discussing about the Siberian crane also, those who are living in this northern region. Now once the winter will start, the Siberian crane will fly and come in Bharatpur bird sanctuary and Sultanpur bird sanctuary, which is in Haryana. They come over there and they are also having such kind of adaptation. They flying with the open mouth, and insects which is traveling in the air, they strike to their mouth and they can collect the food from it, and then they keep on flying. Now all these features of penguin as well as polar bear help them to survive in that polar region. That is very important. Like this adaptation is not like that. Now we as a human being also, we use adaptation. Like when we have summers, we started wearing cotton cloth. Okay, now we will not wear that other clothes, synthetic cloth, we are not going to wear. So we started wearing cotton cloth. So that is also a kind of adaptation. It is not like that. Adaptation can be human made also. Adaptation can be God gifted also. Adaptation can be human made also. Like whatever we required, we make according to our wish. But animals, they cannot make each and everything. So what they do, their body is itself is an adaptation, and their body can provide each and everything. Whatever they require, they require protection from extreme cold. Yes, they have thick fur. They provide protection from severe cold. They have fat which is stored inside their body. They need protection from predators. They have snowy background as well as their color is also white. Then they want to swim. So for that also they have, polar bear can close its nostril for a long time, and they have flat flippers which help them to swim. So these adaptations are very important. Tomorrow we are going to do next adaptation. That's all for today, children. Have a good day.